Hello guys, let's discuss this problem on HackerRank called Java Map. So this question is not a problem, it is not a challenge. It is basically for our understanding of Java Map, so that we understand how to use a map in Java. So basically what is a map? Map is a key and value. So it consists of key and value pairs. So suppose you enter any key of that particular element, you can get that value which is assigned to that, or you can say which is mapped to that value. So that you can say it is kind of like match the pairs, like key is matched to the value or mapped to the value. So fine. First of all, let us code it on IntelliJ. I'll just use my main method, and afterwards, obviously I'll have to create a scanner object. So quickly I'll do that. So scanner system.in. And afterwards, what I'm going to do is I'll have to take an integer n for the number of elements in that map. So integer n equals to, it will be scanner.next int. And after that, I think what I have to do is, so this is the integer n, and after that we have three cases. So this is the first case, this is the second case, this is the third case. So basically we have to use a for loop to take in the name and the contact number, and we'll have to store it in a map, right? So first of all, I'll use a for loop for that. So for any integer I, I'll start it from zero, and it will obviously go up to n, and don't forget to increment it. And after that, I have to take in any not integer actually, I have to take in a name, right? So it won't be an integer, it will be a string. So string name equals to scanner dot next line, actually, because next, hold on, so next scanner dot next line. And why am I using line? Because they are using name and first name and last name also. So basically there is a space in between. So I'll use name integer next line. But before that, okay, hold on, it is name. But before that, the thing is we are taking in an integer, and after that we are taking in a string. And if you are aware in Java, we after taking in an integer, and if you want to take in a string, we have to clear the buffer because of backslash n. So if you don't know that, you can refer to the video that I've already made. So basically what I'm going to do is use scanner.nextLine to clear the buffer so that after taking in an integer, I can take in a string. Okay, fine. And after that, I have to take in the contact number, which will be an integer value. So integer, I'll just call it contact equals to, again, integer scanner.nextInt. This all is fine, but the thing is I have to create a map first. So I'll do one thing, I'll just create the map first. So I'll just, it will be a map, and hold on, map, and if you see it has already suggested us with a key and value. So with a key and value, so the key is going to be the string name that I have. So we have to basically type of the parameter that we are going to use for key and the values in the angular bracket. So the key is going to be the name. So name is a string, and the value is going to be the contact. So contact is nothing but an integer. That's why a string, it will be a map of string comma integer. I'll name it, simply call it map equals to, again, new, then map. Okay, we have to use a hash map. And after that, how many elements? You just write n over here, semicolon. And if you see, IntelliJ automatically imported hash map and all, or you can simply write Java, import java.utility and dot star, so that you get everything. It is fine. So fine, we made a map. We are using a for loop, and now we are going to use the put method that I told that is over here on the Oracle website, official website for Java. So put, so basically it is used for putting a particular key and the value. If you see, the parameters are key and value. So our map's name is map, so with a small name, so small case. So map dot, if you see, we are getting the suggestion. So put key and the value. So dot put, we are going to use name as the key, and value is going to be the contact. So name will be mapped to the particular contact. Fine, we are using this, and I think so this is fine for up to here. So we are using three lines, this is fine. Now we have to basically check in the queries and all for finding them. So we'll go to the end of this for loop, and now what we are doing is we are simply finding. But I think there is one more wrong thing inside it, because the thing is we are using this for loop, we are taking in a string, then we are taking in an integer, but after taking in integer, we are again taking in a string. And I told you all, after integer, if you want to take in the input as string, you'll have to use a scanner.nextLine statement, basically to get rid of, clear the buffer, and to get rid of backslash n. So that's what I did right now. And for each and every for loop, this line will be executed. So everything will be fine for each and every string after the integer input. Now we're going to find the contact. So integer, okay, hold on. to find. So if it says, so the thing is, we don't have how the number of times that we are going to find. So we don't know the count of for loop, that how many times do we have to execute this for loop. So the thing is, if you don't know the count of for loop, what do? You use a while loop. So for that I'll use a while loop, and the condition is going to be while the scanner, if it has something, next line, right? So it, if it has something, then we'll execute it, otherwise the code will basically end over there. Okay, fine, that was about it. Now we have to basically take in a string, and after that just search it, search for it. So I'll just call it integer 2. I want to find something, so I'll just call it to find. Whom do I want to find? I want to use the scanner.nextLine, so I'm not able to find it, so I'll have to type it. So hold on, scanner.nextLine. Okay, I found it, and fine, I am going to take in. But the thing is, after this, okay, it is highlighting me something. Okay, yeah, obviously it will not be an integer, it will be a string. How can I forget it? Because whatever name we are going to find, it is going to be a string. Fine. After that, the thing is, if you find it, you will have to print the key and the value. But if you don't find it, you'll have to print out not found. So in this cases, the logic is really easy. If you find it, you'll use try. If you don't find it, you will catch it, catch the error, and print the statement that they want. So first of all, we'll try to find it. We'll try to find and we'll set it. So first of all, let us call it contact. So I'll just set the contact as, so integer contact. Hold on, it is just giving me some red lines. For that I'll have to use a catch block so that I don't get that. So I'll catch some exception E that I'm not going to use, but still fine. And what I'm going to do is simply print out not found. So I didn't find it, so I printed out not found. And int contact, it is going to be equal to the input that they are giving us, which is nothing but to find. So I don't have to use scanner or whatever it is, scanner next line, because I already took in the next whatever I want to find. So I set it, not, I don't have to set it to this thing actually. I have to use the map method, right? So int contact equals to, I'll use the map that I have, but I'm going to find the contact by using the key, and the key is to find. So for that I'm going to use this method, get method, in which we have to enter the object's key, sorry, the key, and we'll get the value. So to enter the key, get the value, that's what the thing is. So we want to store the value in contact, which is the value, and we want to get the key. So to get the, not to get the key, we have to get the value. For that we'll have to mention the key, which is nothing but to find. And if this thing executes, if basically it will be true when it finds something, and if it does not find something, we'll get an error, and which will be caught and will print not found. That's what we are supposed to do. After that, we are supposed to print out the name of that particular person, which is nothing but to find. Actually, we have to use a equals to sign, and after that we have to print out the contact number, which we have already taken by using the value of that particular key in that map. Now let us just run this code and see if we are right or wrong. And for that I'll have to copy these things, paste them over here, hit enter. Yeah, we found every contact. The contact that it didn't found, that is, we didn't find the contact of Uncle Tom, so it printed out not found, and that's what we are supposed to do. So I'll do one simple thing of copying all the statements and pasting it on HackerRank over here, so that I can verify all the test cases. It's taking a while. Okay, each and every test case is satisfied, there's no error. So you can subscribe to our channel to get updates regarding new videos. That's all. Stay tuned and keep learning. Thank you.